Hello, good morning students. Now, as you people had completed your test, we are moving further with the fourth chapter of English, and the name of the chapter is A Truly Beautiful Mind. And today we will do the first part of this chapter. The whole story is about the life of Albert Einstein. I think you people had already heard the name of Albert Einstein. Fine. So let us start with the chapter, A Truly Beautiful Mind, about Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein was born on 14th of March 1879 in a German city of Ulm, without an indication that he was destined for the greatness. On the contrary, his mother thought Albert was a freak. To her, his height seemed much too large. What does the word freak over here means? Freak means a word used disapprovingly to talk about the person who is usually and doesn't behave or look, think like others. Fine. So, first of all, it is given over here that Albert Einstein was born on 14th of March 1879 in a German city of Ulm. So Ulm is the name of a German city, and it is said that without an indication that he was destined for the greatness. What does it mean? It means that if the person or if the child is born, when the child is born, we do not know what actually the destiny is, how much success the child will achieve. So what the author tries to say over here is that it was not any person, whosoever it is, but we will not be able to judge that what actually the person is going to be or how great success that person is going to achieve. So it was without an indication that he was destined for such a greatness. So the author is saying that it was, no one knows that his destiny is such beautiful that he will achieve such a great success in his life. On the contrary, so on the other part, his mother, means the mother of Albert Einstein, used to believe that Albert Einstein was a freak. Freak means the person who is not, who will not behave like other persons or something like that. And why she used to think that he was like a freak? Because the size of the head of Albert Einstein was much as compared to the heights of the other children. So when she used to look at the other children, she used to think that no, the size of the head of Albert Einstein is much more as compared to the other children's. At the age of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. When he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. So when Albert Einstein was a small child, when he reached at the age of 2.5 years, hum log bhi kabhi kabhi dekhte hai that whenever we are having the small children in our house, they used to speak something, they used to copy us. Fine. At the age of 1 year or 1.5 year, they will learn everything. They will learn how to speak, how to work, everything. But till the age of 2.5 years, Albert Einstein was not able to talk. So he could not talk till the age of 2.5 years. But when finally he started talking or speaking something, what was the problem? That he uttered everything twice. Jo kuch bhi wo bolte the, he used to utter that word twice. Einstein did not know what to do with other children, and his playmates called him Brother Boring. And the mind of the Einstein was working in totally the different direction. So he was not able to adjust himself, or he disliked the things which the small children used to play with, such type of toys like teddy bear or car, aise kuch toys hai, so he did not used to like to play with such types of toys. And so his playmates, means his classmates and all, him called the Brother Boring. So the youngster played by himself with much time. He especially loved mechanical toys. Looking at his newborn sister Marja, he said to have said, "Fine, but where are her wheels?" So youngster means Albert Einstein was a younger brother, and he himself used to spend the time with himself only. And what he used to play, he especially loved the mechanical toys, means कुछ कारीगरी करने को उसको मिल जाती कि कोई स्क्रू निकालना या वैसा कुछ कुछ अच्छा काम जिसमें उसको खुद को इंटरेस्ट था, ऐसा कुछ काम अगर उसको मिल जाता, ही यूज टू लव दैट थिंग. एंड व्हेन हिज न्यू बॉर्न सिस्टर वॉज बॉर्न एंड हर नेम वॉज माजा, ही सेड दैट वेयर आर हर व्हील्स. सो एज ही यूज टू प्ले विद द मैकेनिकल टॉयज, ही वॉज हैबिचुएटेड विद व्हील्स एंड ऑल. सो ही इज सेइंग दैट वेयर आर हर व्हील्स. ओवर योर व्हील्स मीन्स द लेग्स ऑफ दैट न्यू बॉर्न बेबी. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chooses as a profession wouldn't matter because he will never make a success at anything. Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to. He later became a gifted amateur violinist, maintaining the skill throughout his life. So what happened once, the headmaster means the principal of the Albert Einstein's school told his father that what is this, Albert Einstein, whatever he chose as a profession will never make him to achieve the success. Why? Because he will not be able to achieve the success. Why? Because his mind is totally working in the different direction. And as the Albert Einstein's mother was thinking that he should learn to play the violin, so at the age of 6 years, her mother forced him to learn how to play the violin. And so, with the force of the parents, he had learned how to play the violin. And after that, he became amateur, means doing something for personal enjoyment rather than as a profession. So, usko khud ko bhi violin play karne mein maza aati thi, and he was having that skill throughout his life. But Albert Einstein was not a bad pupil. He went to high school in Munich, where Einstein's family had moved when he was 15 months old, and scored good marks in almost every subject. So, no doubt he was able to score good marks in each and every subject. So, what had once happened, the incident is given over here, that when Albert Einstein was a 15 months old, his parents had left him and he was used to stay with his grandfather. So, he went to high school in Munich, where the Einstein's family had moved. So, they had shifted to Munich when Albert Einstein was a 15 months old, and he had scored good marks in every subject. Einstein hated the school's regimentation and often clashed with his teachers. At the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled that there he left the school for good. Regimentation means order or discipline taken to an extreme. Means he used to hate the discipline and the orders that were given by the teachers. And stifled means unable to breathe or suffocated. He used to feel suffocated. Why? Because he was not able to adjust himself in the atmosphere of that school background. And at the age of 15 years, for his goodness, for the betterment of himself, he left the school. Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics, and after finishing school he decided to study at a university in Zurich. But science wasn't the only thing that appealed to dashing young men with a valorous mustache. So Einstein was highly gifted with mathematics, so his power of mathematics was such amazing, and he was also interested in the physics too. So after finishing his school, he decided to study in a university in Zurich. Zurich is the name of a German city. But science wasn't the only thing that appeared to the dashing young man. So he was just something young, as you can see it in the figure as well. And in the figure, whatever it is shown, that is when Albert Einstein was of 21 years of age. So he decided to study in a university in Zurich, but only science was not the thing that will satisfy him. He also felt special interest in a fellow study student, Malevia Merrick, with whom he found to be a clever creature. So he fell in love with this girl named Malevia Merrick, and whom he found to be a clever creature. Means she was one of the amazing girl or the beautiful girl. This young Serb came to Switzerland because university in Zurich was one of the few in the Europe where the women could get the degrees. Why did Malevia Merrick come to this university? Because, sorry, I said over there in the last slide that Zurich is the name of a German city, but it is not the name of a German city. It is in the Switzerland. And what did Albert Einstein said? That why Malevia Merrick came over here to study. The major reason behind this was that it is one of the university in the Europe where the women could get the degree. So there was a ban on certain type of universities where the girls could not get certain types of degrees. Fine, so we will end up with this, and you are supposed to copy the meanings in your fair book. Thank you.